We're in Bromford today, Bromford East, and we're at the pit top, which is above ground, and we've got two TBMs mining all the way to the end point. So right now we're gonna go through the tally hut and then get signed in where they get our IDs and they know who's on the ground at any time. All right, so this is the tally hut where we get to drop all our cards and we get the self-rescue sets before we go down to the TBM. So we're gonna budge the PSV and it's gonna take us into the tunnel where Mary Ann is. And that's the name of the TBM that we're going to. All right, so we're currently on board Mary Ann. We're currently in the pilot's cabin. And this is where he controls the TBM from. Follow the parameters with the pressures and everything he works with. And then we've got the navigation system down there as well. For us to tunnel, we need the grouter in place and we need the pilot as well. And we need segments on the TBM. And when the pilot starts advancing with the TBM, so the cutter head keeps rotating and getting out slurry and material through the slurry lines all the way to the STP at surface where it gets processed. When he finishes that advance of 2 meters, then we use the erector to actually build the segments and then it becomes a whole ring and then we start again. Mary Ann has mined about 1450 rings, that's 1450 rings. The position of the TBM now is currently at the halfway point. We just finished an excavation, so we're currently doing a slurry pipe extension and then we'll get going again. So right now we're currently at the ring build area. So when the TBM pilots finish excavation, he alerts the miners and lets them know that it's time to build a ring. So the ring is fed through the segment feeder to the front to the erector, and the erector picks each segment by segment and places them in the right place. We've got 6 segments and 1 key segment. The key position is determined by the navigation system from the pilot's cab. And we've got, when the segment is all assembled, it becomes a whole ring. And then the pilot is alerted and then he starts mining again. And basically he uses the push ramps to hold the segments back and pushes against the segment that has been built to mine for another 2 meters for the next set of segments. Just right next to us, there is a shaft. So an inspection shaft and an emergency shaft. Should, in case there's an emergency in the tunnel, when the trains are running, people can have an evacuation point. Now the remaining is just to carry on with the TBM and continue mining all the way to Washwood Heath, where we'll break through. We've got another set of colleagues preparing the area for us so that when our TBM arrives, that's Mary Ann, when she arrives there, she can break through successfully. So they're busy and working down there just awaiting our arrival.
So here we are today at Bromford West Portal. This is the location where the TBM is going to come through early part of next year. In preparation over the last 14 months, what we've been constructing is what you can see all around you, which is the reception portal. First TBM, Mary Ann, is going to be coming through early part of next year, and we are preparing our reinforced structure. So over the last 14 months, we have constructed diaphragm walls. We have constructed the 2 major slabs above us. We have completed top-down construction, additional headwall for the TBM to support the TBM breakthrough. And we're now stood on the base slab, ready for the TBM to come through. We've got to create a sump, so we have further excavation to complete down. Just behind me, there's a 7-meter deep drainage sump, which we have to construct in order to take the water coming down the retain cut. This is one element of this and a very important element of receiving the TBM, but this is only one part of the structure. At 22 meters deep as we stand now, we've then got to create a passage through to take the train through up to ground level to daylight at the other end of Washwood Heath and then on to Curzon and central Birmingham. The next phase of our preparation for the TBM coming through is the construction of the railway slab at the bottom of the west portal. So I'm stood next to some of the reinforcement and the thickness of the slab you can gauge by my height is a substantial thickness. We've had one concrete pour so far, which was 1,000 cubic meters, and we're programmed to have our next one, which again is 800 meters. So we've now moved along to the retain cut. We're at 210 metres of the 750 metres. We've been excavated in layers, monitoring the diaphragm walls as we go, closely to see how they react to the excavation in between them as a top-down construction. And we've had a successful removal of some temporary props which retained the structure as we went down. The earth we've moved so far is about 50,000 cubic metres, some of which we've moved to Delta Junction where there's a deficit of material. So now we can see the route of Washwood Heath, the retained cut, heading towards Birmingham city centre. So as you can see, Skanska Bridge behind us is where HS2 line runs underneath, then over Aston Church Road, then onto Saltley retained fill, and then onto Curzon Street in the centre of Birmingham. Over the last 4 years, the Washwood team here have produced a great amount of work. We've produced a real success here, not only with the portal and the retained cut, but also with the platform that you can see behind me.